Welcome back to Sales Insights with Sarah. This is the podcast for sales professionals and business leaders looking to implement new strategies and drive sales growth in their organizations. I'm your host, Sarah Downs, and my guests and I will be sharing with you some of our own experiences in business and sales insights to help you gain focus and take action. Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Sales Insights with Sarah podcast. So today I want to touch on a topic. Do not confuse an elevator pitch with a sales pitch. And the reason for this is I've just done events over the last sort of 3 weeks, and the amount of times where I ask someone to tell me about themselves, or, you know, what's your elevator pitch, if you like, they were jumping in with a sales pitch. Now, you don't know me yet, and therefore you're not going to build rapport by jumping down my throat with a feature bashing sales pitch, as I'd call it. I'm not going to want to get to know you. I'm not going to want to know more about your business. The brick wall is going to go up between us. So therefore, you know, what can we do differently? So in my opinion, an elevator pitch should be relaxed. It should be friendly, conversational, and straight to the point, keeping it simple. Often when people are, you know, asked to tell you a little bit about themselves or try to introduce themselves to you at a networking event, they jump into that bad sales pitching mode where they become a motor mouth, and it's as if they're trying to fit in as much information and as many words as possible within about a 30 or 60 second time. And I understand that the elevator pitch to many people is a 60 second pitch, but that does not need to be 60 seconds of feature bashing sales. At the end of the day, the person that you're talking to that you've just met for the first time, they don't care. And really, this is the very start of this building the relationship with them. But I get it. I understand that you want to provide a brief into what your company does. But think about the value proposition here. You need to understand what you provide to who. And when I say the what, I don't mean the, you know, the technical information. I mean the value. You know, what value can you provide? What need or pain or challenge do your customers have that you have a solution to? And who are your customers? But you can say this without even having to mention what your product or service is. If you think about some of the most famous value propositions out there, they don't talk about the software, they don't talk about the technology, they talk about the solution that they have for their clients or their customers, depending if they're in the B2B or B2C space. You want to keep it simple. We want to get to the point as quickly as possible, and then we want to turn it back on them. At the end of the day, the more you learn about the person you're talking to, the more you're going to be able to qualify. If the more you know about them, you'll understand whether you even have something that can help them, whether you are a good fit for them. But if you don't have a conversation, you're making an assumption. And the more assumptions you make, the more people you're going to upset and turn off from your business. I think one of the biggest mistakes I see in, I guess, the elevator pitch, and don't get me wrong, I do work in technical sectors most of the time, but people are so quick to jump in with acronyms and technical jargon, industry-specific language within that elevator pitch. And if this is what you're doing, you're going to have a hard time engaging the majority of the people that you speak to. Because even if they are working in a technical sector, it does not mean that they are technical. For example, if you're at a conference or a networking event, the chances are that the person you're talking to is another salesperson. But have you taken the time to decide that? Have you really got to know who you're talking to before you open your mouth? So again, try and keep it simple. Get to the point very quickly and then turn it back on them. And the other bit of advice I'd give is, if you're passionate about something, if you're energetic as an individual, is that shining through? because a number of the pitches that I've had lately have been very monotone, and it sounds like the person hates their job. It sounds like they don't believe in their product or service, or even in the company that they're working for. So please be mindful of that. And what I'd say is, if you're somebody that isn't yet clear on your elevator pitch, or that you get nervous and therefore, you know, it all just falls apart as soon as you start talking to somebody, then practice, rehearse as much as it possible or as much as it takes to get it right. And the more networking you do, the more people that you speak to, the easier that it will get. I remember when I first left nursing and was told to go to a networking event, I was terrified. And I will do another episode on that at a later date. But it took a lot of practice. It took years, actually, for me, because I didn't have anybody mentoring me. I didn't have content like this to listen to and learn from at my fingertips. So I had to get it wrong time and time and again and learn. And I want everyone that's listening to this to hopefully take something away from it. You know, look in the mirror a little bit. How do you act, and how do you speak to somebody when you first meet them at an event? Are you truly doing an elevator pitch, or are you jumping into sales pitching mode? So that's it from me today. I hope that everyone is well, and I'll speak to you all soon. Take care. Thank you for listening to the Sales Insights with Sarah podcast. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already, so that you are notified of every new episode. If you could take a few minutes to leave a review, it would be greatly appreciated. See you next time.